Cheers to the designated driver. Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez. On this program, you and I will explore the innovations and advances that technology can contribute to improving the Filipino way of life. We'll upload information and ideas on the hardware and software that will make you aware of new directions that can lead to better ways of doing things. There's no time like the present to think about a future perfect. Beer-guzzling folk all over the world recently celebrated the 200th anniversary of Munich's Oktoberfest tradition. At just about the same time, former President and now Pampanga Congresswoman Gloria Arroyo pushed for a new law that defines the legal limit to being drunk behind the wheel. So while tipsy tipplers were rolling out the barrels, our lawmakers were busy thinking of ways to stop them from rolling out afterwards with their cars.
No, I didn't have anything to drink.
Oh, okay.
What is it?
I'm a judge.
Riding in a car with a drunk driver can make for a hilarious scene if you're the 40-year-old virgin played by Chief Carell.
I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. I think I kind of had that coming.
But drinking and driving is never this funny in real life. It can be downright disastrous. Philippine authorities have no consolidated data on the number of drunk driving accidents throughout the country. But for its part, the Police Highway Patrol Group has reported 279 drunk driving cases nationwide in the first quarter alone of 2010. The same report shows an estimated increase of 152% in drunk driving cases from 2007 to 2009. Driving while intoxicated is considered a mere traffic violation under current Philippine law. The penalties are far from severe. A provision in the Land Transportation and Traffic Code says anyone caught while driving under the influence of liquor will be fined not less than 200, but not more than 500 pesos. A violator could also be imprisoned for not more than 3 months at the discretion of the court. Various anti-drunk driving bills are now pending at both the Senate and the House of Representatives, all of them proposing to increase the penalties for violators. The Senate has 4 versions, the House has 3, including one filed by former President and now Pampanga 2nd District Representative Gloria Arroyo. In her bill, co-authored with her son, Dato, Congresswoman Arroyo notes how drunk driving has become the second leading cause of traffic accidents in the Philippines. A previous bill filed by Senator Pia Cayetano in 2004 nearly described a driver as considered drunk when his or her appearance suggests that he or she has consumed sufficient level of alcohol as to affect the control of his or her faculties. Senator Cayetano's bill specified drunk driving indicators such as over-speeding, slurred speech, and breath odor. But it wasn't until recently that bills to penalize drunk driving have specified a BAC, a blood alcohol count, which measures the amount of alcohol for every 100 milliliters of a person's blood. In the U.S., the legal BAC limit is 0.08%. equivalent to an intake of at least 3 to 5 bottles of beer. A report citing a toxicologist at the UP Poison Center says a typical 300 milliliter bottle of beer is enough to impair the driving skills of a 154-pound man. Proposals pending in Congress have set VAT limits ranging from 0.06 to 0.08%. The Automobile Association of the Philippines cites a U.S. study that shows a driver with a BAC of 0.08% is at least 11 times more likely to be killed in a car crash than a sober driver. The proposed anti-drunk driving legislation can also provide for random sobriety tests, such as those done in the U.S. The World Health Organization has determined that police checkpoints that conduct random breath testing of drivers can reduce the number of fatal car accidents by as much as 42%. Most cities in the Philippines have anti-drunk driving ordinances, Makati City backed up its ordinance by taking suspected drunk drivers to the Hospital ng Makati, where their BAC is tested. Drivers who register a .13 BAC are considered unfit to drive and can be charged as violators. So we didn't get to attend any Oktoberfest celebration, so instead of Future Perfect going to a bar, the bar has come to us. And we're glad to have the Party Fuel Mobile Bar people, bartender Verhel over there, dazzling us with his acrobatic stunts. Of course, they're not just here to serve us drinks. They'll also help us get ready for a little test the MMDA will give us after a couple of rounds. I mean, reports. Well, once an anti-drunk driving law is in place, what next? For the measure to have any teeth, traffic enforcers must be able to easily and reliably gauge the intoxication levels of suspected drunk drivers. Enter the breathalyzer.
Everyone knows that putting a drunk behind the wheel is a bad idea. But how are cops supposed to figure this out? They can, of course, administer sobriety tests, but needless to say, these aren't very specific, and only a little better than the look and smell test. To measure blood and alcohol concentration, traffic enforcers must be armed with a device known as a breathalyzer. It measures the amount of alcohol in the air you exhale.
Hihihit siya dito sa nozzle nito for 5 seconds, no? At lalabas dito naman, lalabas dito yung alcohol content ng kanyang blood. So kung lumabas na, kunyari, meron na tayong ilo, lumabas ng 0.06, then mapipinalize siya.
In the U.S., where the fine for drunk driving can reach as high as $12,000, people have thought for ways to beat the breathalyzer. They try to do this by chewing on mint or bubble gum to mask the alcohol, or sucking on copper pennies or even batteries, which supposedly interferes with the electronic sensors of the device, but none of these really work. Breathalyzers are so reliable that some Americans even buy their own to find out if they can legally get behind the wheel. There are, of course, those who still insist on driving drunk, even after numerous DUI convictions. For people like these, U.S. courts sometimes require the installation of an ignition interlock. It's basically a breathalyzer connected to the car's ignition system. To start a car, a person must first breathe into the device. If they fail the test, the ignition gets locked and the car won't start. At random times after the engine has been started, the device will ask for another breath sample. This is to ensure that an intoxicated driver does not try to cheat by asking a sober friend to breathe into the device. Some car makers, meanwhile, are taking things a step further. Nissan is developing a car that has alcohol odor sensors, a facial monitoring system, and other devices that alert the car about the driver's erratic driving behavior. While these technologies are quite promising, there are still no substitutes for good old common sense.